Good evening, everybody. So yes, I do come from CAC. It's an honor to be here with you all tonight. I'd like to thank the team at the Child Advocacy Center of the Bluegrass for bringing me here to speak to all of you. I've never touched down in the state of Kentucky, so this is quite an adventure, as you can imagine. A special thank you to Jackie and Whitney for driving me around all day and showing me some of Kentucky today and tomorrow. So my name is Melanie. I'm a forensic interviewer at Children's Home, the Cape Islands Child Advocacy Center in Massachusetts. It was surely a treacherous but beautiful road to get here. One of my favorite quotes is, "Difficult roads lead to beautiful destinations." And I agree so greatly. Every time I get to share my story and voice across the country is a beautiful destination for me. I'm a fiance. I just got engaged in February. I'm a daughter, an avid softball player, a Camp Sunshine volunteer, a faithful friend, a member of Harbor Church, and so much more. I am a survivor of more than my story. I'd like to tell you a little bit about how I went from victim to survivor to thriving and shining and working at a CAC myself as a forensic interviewer and how important the CAC model was for me. I carried shame from the first time hands touched my body without my consent. I was sexually abused when I was 9 to 10 by my after-school babysitter's teenage sons, and again at 12 years old, I was sexually assaulted by my best friend at the time's relative in broad daylight at an elementary school. My trust was broken, I was broken, and I vowed I would never tell. I didn't know how I could. I couldn't imagine how I could and how I would. Everything changed in an instant. The social butterfly and ham in front of the camera kind of girl I was, along with my bubbly spirit, started to fade away. Light became darkness, and I wasn't sure I would see the light again. I wasn't sure I'd find my way back to the light that I illuminated so powerfully my first 9 years of life. I battled self-injury and restricting my eating almost immediately, and I never thought I'd see light again. Months after my sexual assault at 12 years old, I would find myself walking into the Child Advocacy Center in my home state of New Hampshire. Walking into the CAC, I was greeted with a friendly face, a smile, and for the first time in a long time, I felt safe. I could sense that the woman standing in front of me, my friends and interviewer, Christy, understood, and that she believed me. I disclosed that day, and the trajectory of my journey changed for the better, forever. At the end of the interview, I was brought to a shelf and baskets filled with teddy bears. And actually, can I have someone from my table grab the bear in my bag that I forgot over there? It's an important part, so bear with me. It's my new friend over there. She's going to get a bourbon or something later. At the end of the interview, I was brought to a shelf and baskets filled with teddy bears. I was told that I could choose any bear that I wanted to take home with me as a token of my courage. I was ultimately and literally given the gift of hope when I walked out of the CAC that day. I chose this bear 17 years ago. I brought this with me tonight to show you the true impact of the Child Advocacy Center and what it can have for a family and child who's been through it. This bear has the word hope on its foot. Only my front people can see it. And I remember the day I walked out of the CAC, and I remember my 12-year-old brain thinking, there's hope for me. I don't have to live with the secret anymore, I'm free. I saw the light again. Because of the CAC, I started my journey of healing and holding on to hope and light and darkness no matter what the journey has entailed. Through my struggles and the aftermath of the abuse, I held on to this hope there and light as a reminder that I found my voice and I no longer had to be trapped and silenced by the secret. That with hope comes freedom. Walking out of the CAC, shame was lifted, my voice was found. 2 years later, the case from when I was 12 went to trial. And because I found my voice at the CAC, I was able to give a victim impact statement at 14 years old and get my power back. When I walked out of the courtroom in 2006 at 14, I knew I would get back to this field in CAC someday. I was determined to find purpose in my pain. The forensic interviewer, the detective on my case, and the victim witness advocate at the courthouse became my dream team. They always believed me, believed in me, and encouraged me so much along the way. They brought me back to light and hope. This is the value of the empathy team. My forensic interviewer and I reconnected 7 years after she interviewed me. And since 2012, we have traveled across New Hampshire and the country to share our story of reconnection. And we aim to remind us all why we do this work. My dream team was present at my college graduation party, which meant so much to me. It's a truly powerful thing when someone lights your flame and keeps it going. As years went by, I continued to find my voice, which ignited my passion to be a voice for survivors in all capacities. I've worked in victim services for 9 years now, in various roles, and because of the CAC, I can carry my hope and light through my experience to others without shame. My responsibility now is to shine, so is yours. My hope is hearing me speak tonight will light the flame in you to support the CAC movement, and if you are working in it, to continue to do what you are doing with your whole heart, because it is the reason I'm standing up here tonight. For the past 5 years, I have worked as a family advocate at the CAC in my hometown, where I live, not my hometown, but now that's my home. And in March of this year, I shifted roles to forensic interviewer at the same CAC. It's been humbling and so amazing to go from where I was to where I am. It's been humbling to be a part of an MVT. It's been humbling and so amazing to watch the CAC movement grow. Without the CAC, that would not have been possible. The definition of rise, part of our theme tonight, an upward movement, an instance of becoming higher, my definition would say brighter. The definition of shine, another theme tonight, to give out a bright light, to direct that light somewhere to see something dark, something brighter. Survivors go on to do incredible things. We may never know the end result, but your work matters and your contribution matters. To shine is the epitome of being the light, not the darkness, for ourselves and for others. Even on the hardest and darkest days of my journey, I've always desired and aspired to be a beacon of hope and light, like a lighthouse on the shore guiding others to safety. I try to be bold with my experiences to let others know that they are not alone. And this is exactly what guiding others to shine will allow survivors and those who support them to do. My hope is that other survivors around the world who are trapped in darkness from this type of violation will see the light and step out to the light for themselves. We can all be part of the ripple effect of positive, encouraging, and beautiful light shining on survivors from around the world. I've always believed in my heart that if you find your voice, it can change your life. The little things matter. The little things are the big things. This CAC planted that reality for me, and I'm forever humbled and thankful to shine here tonight because of it, and because of you, kids like me have access to the CAC. As a woman with a strong faith, a passionate voice, and a compassionate heart, it has been my honor to share my journey with all of you and to be here tonight to rise and shine for the Child Advocacy Centers in Kentucky with all of you.